So I want to discuss with you one of the deeper concepts that I never actually talked about, and it's what I call the enlightened perspective, or you could also call it the Christ being or any sort of religious connotation like that. And this is the epiphany that I had in Thailand, which I talk about in my book. This is one of the most life-changing epiphanies that I've ever had, and it happened throughout many, many years. And I want to tell you already that if you can grasp this concept and actually apply it and live it, this will be the most significant improvement to your life that you've ever experienced. This will change everything about the way you live life and about how and the way life treats you, from the way people treat you to the way you engage in social situations, to the way you treat your health, to your lifestyle level. Everything will change. And the way I want to introduce this is by talking about another concept that I never talk about, which is how the root of what you feel inside, your level of ego and resistance to life, will always quickly or sometimes over a long time dictate your level of lifestyle. So what does this mean? I've lived my life with pretty low self-esteem. My baseline is kind of low self-esteem, even today. It's always like inside, when I don't actually do anything, my default is feeling bad, it's being anxious, it's just not feeling good. So whatever happens in my life, if I don't put effort, if I just go on the default, my life is shit. But then even if I apply a lot of effort and make it better, and let's say I increase my lifestyle from this to this, if I stop applying effort, it will always eventually come back to this. So if it's wealth, I'll find a way to destroy it. If it's friends, I'll find a way to lose them. So you always go back to your baseline. And your baseline, again, it's a spiritual thing. Your baseline is dictated by how much ego you have, how much you resist life and what is at this moment, what is in the present moment. So the way that started changing, it started when I was about 16, 17, about 17 or 18 years old. I went to a desert festival called an ashram, and I met a spiritual teacher there who's not really like a spiritual teacher. It was a guy and a girl, and they both said that they were enlightened, but they weren't like these gurus who had spiritual teachings or anything like that. It's like they were simply themselves, but there was something different about them, some sort of a lack of effort. Like they never actually put effort in anything. Everything flowed naturally. And I was right off the bat attracted to them for some unknown reason. Like I wanted to know more about it. And in the few days that I was there, I had the most life-changing epiphany at the time when I learned from them that my thoughts, the thoughts in my head, are not actually my thoughts. Meaning that thoughts, you know, they come and go, like, oh, thought, another thought, another thought. And you can't control the next thought. So let's say they said, like, okay, let's say I get you to choose, okay, do you want a red shirt or a blue shirt? So you choose, red. So then you think you made that choice. Like, yeah, I chose red. But when you actually become like aware and look deeply into it, you notice that you didn't actually choose red. What happened was the thought red and the impulse came into your mind from nowhere. And then you identified with that impulse and then you said red. But where did that thought come from? You did not create that thought. The thought came from nowhere. And then you identify with the thought and you say, okay, that's what my choice then. And something clicked in my head when that happened. And I realized that I'm not really in control of anything. I realized that through awareness, you can notice that even if you stop putting effort into your body moving, for example, you will still do, your body will keep moving autonomously without any conscious input. And if you stop putting effort into thinking, your thoughts will just come naturally. And you realize that you don't really have any control over anything. It's like you notice life happening and you think you have this illusion that you're in control because you identify with certain actions or thoughts. Like, for example, I could be thinking right now, like, oh, what about this? What should I do? And what do I do later? But it doesn't matter what I think because I'm not actually in control of my body. My body will just do what it's going to do. So let's say, you know, right now I'm sitting and talking. It just comes from nowhere. If you actually become present to the moment and notice it, you see your thoughts are coming on their own accord. The actions, me moving, speaking, and it's all happening naturally without me putting in effort. And where the resistance comes from is your belief that you can somehow change that. You can change your actions through your thoughts or something like that. So let's say you're in a social situation and you want to say something, or you're like, oh, I should have done this. I should do this. You're like, you micromanage your life. When you sit still, you micromanage, oh, I should do this, or I should do that. You constantly worry, what should I do? You know, present, you worry about like future, past. And when you realize that you don't really have control over anything, you just stay present with where you are, because it doesn't really matter what you think about the future, because you're not going to be able to change it anyway. And even if right now you want to do something, nothing guarantees that you'll do it in the next minute. So I can say, tomorrow I'm going to do this, or the next minute I'm going to do this. And then what ends up happening is that you do something completely different. You're not actually in control over anything. And I know this sounds crazy, but this is sort of a thing that you can verify for yourself. If you just become present to the moment, you can verify it. Now, where am I going with this? Almost all the trouble in my life started always when I identify with myself, you know, with my thoughts and my actions. I'm like, oh, I can affect things. So I take these things personally. So if I have a bad thought, I take it personally. Or if I do something wrong, I'm like, oh, I should have done this, I should have done that. Instead of realizing, hey, I'm not even in control of my body, I'm not in control of anything, so there's no point in feeling bad about anything. And when you adopt that enlightened perspective, that Christ awareness, Christ, because you can see no wrong, you can't see anything wrong, life starts changing immediately. Like socially, you're going to be sharp because you're not going to be reactive to other people. So all you're going to be aware of is, hey, now I'm doing this, now I'm doing that. And you're going to just let things happen without putting in any effort. And suddenly life is going to respect you back and good things are going to happen. So all the good times in my life over the last few years, all the prosperity and abundance happened when I let life happen, when I let go of the wheel and I let go of trying to control things and I just accept what happens as it is. Now, you might be thinking this is some sort of a passive thing, like, oh, let's be passive or let's be, what's the word? Apathetic. I'm not sure I'm saying it right, but apathy, basically. This is not it, because this is not about not trying in life. It's about trusting in life to do what is right. And whenever you try to go against that process, that is ego, and that creates friction, that creates negative things. And again, whenever I had the abundance, it's because I let things happen. So clients came naturally. I made the right calls. I did the right things. And the reason for that is because I don't self-sabotage when I let things happen. I don't self-sabotage. And then when I stop trusting in life, when I start going against life by saying, this isn't right. This shouldn't be happening. I shouldn't be doing this. I should be doing that. When you stop trusting in life and ego kicks in, you self-sabotage and drag your life down immediately. And again, I just wanted to share this with you because I thought it was a good time. As you know, I've been in a pretty bad situation for a couple of months. And today was like the first day that I remembered it. It's like I keep forgetting that life happens and that I'm not really in control. And then I become really attached to what happens. And then life starts going bad. And then during the periods where I'm more up, more manic sometimes, or sometimes just out of an epiphany, I remember, oh yeah, I forgot to trust life. And then immediately life becomes a lot better. So what I want you to take from this is start practicing some awareness of how you are resisting things that you can't really affect. Start developing awareness and seeing that you're not really in control and that you keep forgetting that all the time. And that whenever you forget that you're not in control of your body or of your thoughts, bad things start to happen. Things like worrying and being out of the flow of life. And notice, again, if this video inspires you or gives you that epiphany, notice that when you let go, when you don't judge life, when you see, okay, now my body's doing this, now it's doing that, this is the thought. You just let life happen. You become really aware, really present to the moment. Life starts working in your favor immediately. Like almost immediately you see, maybe you make a really good phone call and that starts things, gets things going. Maybe suddenly you just get up and walk out of the house and just do something new. Because you let life happen, you get out of the confines of the ego. Okay, next point. What are the recommended books for this kind of thing? Unfortunately, there is no one book that teaches what I just told you about. There are some gurus that I personally know that do teach this personally, but they don't have like a book for it. I've never actually found a book that kind of tells that as it is, but I have been able through mentors and gurus and books to come to these conclusions with time. And one book I can recommend highly is The Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle. That's a really good start. Another book is the trilogy of Jed McKenna. It's called The Enlightenment Trilogy. Really tough book. Like this is a book that's like a no bullshit book about enlightenment, but not like the kind you think of. So when I'm talking about enlightenment, I'm not talking about, you know, fairy tales and, you know, flying heaven or any religious thing. When I say enlightenment, I mean the awareness of things happening of their own accord. It's called non-dual awareness. Dual because there's good, there's bad. There's I should do this. I'm doing it right. I'm not doing it wrong. When you kind of go for a higher perspective, the enlightened perspective, as I call it, what happens is you let go of the polarities of life. So the good, the bad, you just kind of accept where you are. Again, why do you accept where you are? Because you realize that you can't be anywhere else. So let's say I'm eating something that I shouldn't be eating. Yes, that's what's happening right now. So if I'm eating, I'm like, no, I shouldn't be eating. This is bad. This is really bad. What happens is you resist it internally. And by resisting it, you self-sabotage. You actually attract more of that. But if you're just like, accept it fully, like be in it. Like, okay, yeah, I'm eating it. Yeah. And really just let go. Again, not try to push it forward, but not try to avoid it. You just get to a higher perspective of it's not good, it's not bad, it's just what is right now. the bad action is not going to become a habit, a bad habit. It's just going to be happen and then done. And then when you don't self-sabotage, what happens is you start taking actions out of inspiration rather than desperation. Because most of the time, we're running away from things. We're always like, I should be doing this. I should be doing that. This is good. This is bad. And you're always in the cycle. So even if you put a lot of effort and you get good results, again, it's not sustainable because it's coming. It's happening only because you're applying a ton of pressure. But once you stop applying that pressure, again, it's going to disappear very, very quickly. And there's many people that experience this, not just in spirituality, in business, in relationships, sometimes in all areas at once, like me. And like, again, many people that this happened to. So I hope this doesn't sound too wishy-washy. This is something that I'm reminded of throughout my life. And especially in the last couple of years, it's like, it's almost as if all the bad shit that happens in my life, it happens to remind me to go back to this. So sometimes I might go through months of punishment because I forgot that I'm not in control, that wherever I am, that's where I should be because I can't be anywhere else. So I think life is leading me on this kind of enlightenment perspective. I think it's leading everybody. Again, if you read Eckhart Tolle or Jed McKenna, they talk a lot about how life, the eventual destination of life is enlightenment because you're going to die. And the moment of death is like the moment of enlightenment, because when you face your death, you realize you really have nothing more to lose. And not everybody gets there, but that's like the, again, it's really fuzzy to explain. But one-on-one, I can definitely explain it a lot better because I can use personal awareness to explain it. So again, I know this is not an easy video. I like to present my videos in a very clear, you know, 1, 2, 3 type concept, you know, step one, step two, stuff that's really logical. This is really hard to explain logically, especially since, you know, I've not done it for a while. But again, hear me out. The best times of my life, times where I had abundance of everything, of relationships, of money, and not just abundance in terms of amounts, also in the way you get it. I didn't have to work hard for it. It's like it came to me, where when I was in that enlightened perspective. And what happened is a lot of the times things got so good that I started to develop ego attachment and think, oh, this is me. I deserve it. It's because of me. It's not that life gave it to me. I got it because of me. And then when it's taken a bit away from you, you go crazy because, again, life is now not working based on the way you identify that it should work. And you freak out and then you self-sabotage. It's like your girlfriend or boyfriend does a takeaway. A takeaway is when you're in a relationship or dating somebody and that person goes cold, you know, becomes like kind of not responsive for a few days to see if you become needy. Girls do that a lot more than guys, but guys do that some of the time. And if the girl notices that when she becomes cold, you become needy all of a sudden, she loses attraction because she realizes you're only charismatic when she acts the way you want her to act. So it's based on ego, not on internal confidence that's not dependent on certain situations being positive. So life challenges you. It takes away the good things that you get when you reach that enlightened perspective. And then if you stay calm and stay with the faith, you get usually rewarded big time. But life will test you. So I've been tested many times and I failed many times. But when I didn't fail, when I stayed in that trusting way, like, okay, bank account's not good,
it's okay. I'm trusting life. I'm trusting that it couldn't be otherwise anyway. Suddenly it gets 10 times better. And it's a way to live that is almost completely stress-free. Negative emotions don't affect you. Almost not any effect. Nor do positive emotions, because you live in a higher plane where you're above that positive-negative shit. Because let's say you're happy because something really good happened. It happened because it happened. So you don't develop the ego attachment, so you don't risk losing it. But again, if you something bad happens, you also don't identify with it, and then you stay in that positive state. So I hope this video helps you. Again, this is the biggest epiphany I've had in my life. It came in through many years and many kind of going down the rabbit hole, starting with the ashram in the desert and really kind of going full circle in Thailand. Because as you might know from my videos or my book, I spent the last 2 weeks there just writing, trying to get to the truth of what's going on in reality, you know, in my head and consciousness. And, you know, 300, 400 pages later, I just literally was in the hotel room from morning till night just writing. I kind of went full circle with it. And for the next few months, literally for a couple of months, I lived in that enlightened perspective. And that's when I had like the most abundance in my life, in all areas of life. So I'm making this video for you to learn that and to try to adopt it. Again, if your life is good right now, adopt it, because you let go and then you're going to get more abundance, and you're going to guarantee that you're not going to self-sabotage. And if your life is bad, again, the reason it's bad is because you're self-sabotaging. Because just if you logically think about it, there's so much wealth in this world, so much money, trillions of dollars, hundreds of trillions of dollars. And there's so many opportunities. Every person is an opportunity. Every idea is an opportunity. There's so much abundance in this world of people that you can date, that you can get money from, that you can service, that there's an infinite, like they call it in spirituality, the infinity, because it is infinite. If you're not tapping into it, if you're not experiencing it, if all you're experiencing is lack, what that means is that you're stuck in the negative side of ego, which is scarcity, the opposite of abundance. So you should also apply this, because when you go into that enlightened perspective, life is going to start working for you rather than against you. Because again, you're the one self-sabotaging, because life is trying to flow and you're constantly trying to change the flow, but you can't really change the flow. You can only resist it, and it creates really, really bad results. You could almost say that it's the point of life is to become like aligned with life, to get that enlightened perspective. And that's why you get punished when you go with the ego, with the abundance or scarcity in the ego mindset, versus when you kind of disidentify and go up. So if you have any questions regarding this topic, feel free to ask me. I'd love to help you. And again, the second reason I made this video is for me. It's as a reminder, because I keep being pummeled by life. I keep being hit hard by life because I go hard at life, and being reminded again and again and again that this is really the key to living life well. There's the surface level, which is, you know, learning business, reading books, positive health habits, stuff like that, basically external things. But until you fix that core, until you fix that root level and attain that enlightened perspective, nothing is really going to change, because even if it's going to get better, it's always going to go, you're always going to find a way to self-sabotage. Your life is always going to be filled with drama and problems. And the enlightened gurus, you know, the enlightened teachers I met in the ashram, they are truly enlightened because they, it's called an abiding non-dual awareness. So they're not just in an, they don't just have that awareness like me some of the time, they have it all the time. And that's why their life is so just flowing and stress-free. Now, that doesn't mean that bad things don't happen to them. It means that they are always in an upward cycle. So even if bad things happen to them, they quickly correct, because it's still, you still live in reality where there are good and bad things, but you're always in an up cycle because life goes, the natural direction of life is to grow. There's this famous saying that life supports what supports life. So I'm not some master. Again, I'm learning this as I go, but I can say with scientific level of proof, like, hey, here's where I was in this state, here's where I wasn't, that the more time you can spend in this enlightened perspective, the more time you are aware and not resisting, the better your life will be. When I had experiences of a few weeks or months of being in this awareness, I experienced immense abundance that I can't even describe to you. Everything is amazing. Everything, like, life just works. It's like almost like a movie, how amazing it is. And then sometimes you just spend a bit of time in that enlightened awareness and you instantly start seeing your life go up and up because you introduce spontaneity into your life. Suddenly you start doing things that you would never do before. You're no longer a victim of habit. You become like a free roamer, like a vagabond. Like, things just happen, and it's always the right thing because it comes out of inspiration. There's an underlying enlightened action behind it, because you're not doing it out of looking for a reaction. You're doing it because this is what you're doing right now. So socially, you start becoming much more charismatic and creating amazing social situations. Same with business, same with health. You start being spontaneously inspired. And again, you don't self-sabotage. So now that I reached the 30-minute mark, I think we can call it a wrap. I also want to tell you how I learned a lot in the last few days from just sharing with you guys how life wasn't working for me for the last few months. Really not working. And thank you so much for the support, like the messages I got. You know, I got just a couple of comments, but, you know, behind the scenes, I got so many messages from people who wanted to help. And I've always been somebody that doesn't share his problems, that when things are good, I'm here helping, inspiring. When things are bad, I just go into hiding. And this was the first time that I allowed myself to truly be vulnerable and just express myself in the last video. So thanks a lot for the support. This is really life-changing for me. And for the first time in the last couple of months, I can honestly tell you that I'm actually excited about life again, excited about the future and what's going to happen. I've really been in hell for the last couple of months. It's been horrible. So thanks for being on this journey with me. And hopefully, you know, this will be a huge success story. And a couple of years later, you could say, oh, I knew that guy, you know, I supported him from the start. So thanks a lot. And again, if you have any questions, please ask. And, you know, I'll see you very soon. So goodbye.